Hey guys, what's up? I know it's been forever since I've made a video on MicroTechTutorials, but you know what? I'm back, and let's get started with some Minecraft videos straight away. So, my Minecraft videos have gotten a lot of views, which is awesome, and someone wanted to know how you protect things, and it's pretty simple. You just have to use WorldGuard, but in order to use WorldGuard, you need WorldEdit because they go hand in hand because WorldGuard, WorldEdit, go figure, they are similar plugins. So WorldGuard is used to protect things, so you can limit it to certain people, so only certain people can build in an area, only people can enter an area, so you can make it so they can't even walk in unless they're a certain person or a certain group of people. So you can restrict it so only VIPs can build in a certain area or only VIPs can enter a certain area. But that's for a different video. This video is going to be about WorldEdit, which lets you build super fast in Minecraft, and it just comes in handy a lot. And you can also use it to move stuff. So I have opened the WorldEdit download, so I'm just going to download the jar only version. So I'm going to go ahead and hit save, and then I'm going to go ahead and hit show in folder. I'm going to copy this, and then I'm going to paste it in my plugins folder. So here's my server itself, and I want to go ahead and start. Let's give it 8 gigabytes of RAM today, and here we go. And now I just want to open up Minecraft, so let me do that. Alright, sorry, it was on my other display, but it should be easier for my tutorials now that I have two displays. So I'm going to go ahead and type in localhost, or you can type whatever your IP is in, but I'm just running this server locally. And there we go, it says blah 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 blah, I have joined. Alright, so here we go. So now I just want to reload the server. So type /rl, and it says it reloaded. Now, what commands do people get, and how do you set up permissions? Well, you can go through and individually give people certain commands, which can take a long time, or you can just do WorldEdit dot and then a star, like it says right there, WorldEdit dot star, and it gives them all WorldEdit permissions. So let's say you want to give all your VIP members of your server VIP, you can go ahead and do that. Alright, so now that we're here, let's say we want to change something. Hold on, let me change my game mode. /creative. Alright, so let me clear my inventory first. Alright, so let's say I want to go ahead and make a flat surface. So what I want to do is get my wand out. And what the wand lets you do is let you change things. So let's say I left click this corner, I'm going to fly up. And I'm going to click on that corner. And then I can set it to something. So /set0. And it just deleted that part. So you can go around just deleting things this way. So if I set this to 0, it deletes it. Or I can do set and then something like wood. And it changed it to wood. And you can use IDs that way. So if you have a long thing, and let's just say you have something like, I don't know, let's get a couple blocks. Let's say you have something like a block right there, and you want it to extend all the way over here, but you want to make it easy to do so, you can just take your wand, left click, right click, and I can set to gold. So that's nice, and it's pretty easy to do. So what if you want to select an entire direction of the map, and that's pretty easy to do. So let's say I want every single brick from here to there to be one thing. Now, I wouldn't recommend doing this, but you could do /expand. And you can either do vert, which is vertical, so you can, or you can do it horizontally. But I'm gonna do vert, and then it selected all the blocks, and I'm gonna do /set0. And here you can tell. Now, if I look up, there are no blocks anywhere in my path. So that's just a few basic commands. You can do other things, like let's say I want to copy and paste this. So I want to go ahead and copy it, right click, So let's say I have it, and I'm going to stand in the middle because you want it relatively close. So I'm going to do /copy. And if I go right here and do /paste, it pastes it, and you have to be in the middle, and it will do it based on your location. So you want to make sure you stand in the middle of where you are and at the right level. So if you're copying something down here, you want to stand in the middle down here so it copies everything above you. So it's pretty easy to move stuff that way. So if I wanted to undo that, I could do /cut, and it would go ahead and cut those blocks. /paste. And to undo something, you just do /undo. So those are some simple commands you can do. It's pretty easy. There's a lot of other things you can do. You can, like I said, those are just a couple things you can do. You can replace blocks with this plugin. You can move things up and down and stuff like that. But that's pretty much the basics. But just a few other commands real quick I'm going to go over. So let's say you have something like water and you want to drain it. Oh no, how am I going to get rid of all this water? /drain. But I'm going to have to give it a radius, so I'm just going to say 20. And it drains all the blocks within that distance. And I'm just going to undo this. So I'm going to do /undo. And it brings back water. And it's really easy to do. And that's pretty much it. You can also do snow. You can do thaw. There's other things you can do, and it's just really cool. There's a whole list of commands. I will have a reference sheet and everything you need to know for more additional commands, but those are just some basic commands of how to download and install and go ahead and copy and paste and then drain stuff and then selecting things and just the basics of it. I could go on for about a half hour minimum, but I'm going to spare you guys some time, let you guys play around with it. And it's really easy, really, once you get started. It's just a matter of getting started using it. And it's one of the plugins you have to have, and most servers will actually have. So go ahead, check it out. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like this video. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe for more future Minecraft videos. I will catch you guys later.